Oh, shit.
Speech. First of all, I want to thank my connect, the most important person with all due respect.
And we're
thanks
back.
The duffel bag, the brown paper bag, the Nike shoe box for holding all his cash.
I'll turn us up.
Boys in blue who would grieve before the bag.
I'll turn us up.
The first pusher who ever made the stash.
I'll turn us up.
The rock boys in the building tonight.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know where you at in 2024, but wherever you are, turn us up.
Bullet wounds will stop your buffoonery. Thanks to the pastor rapping at your eulogy. To Little Kim and them, you know the women friend who carry the word cross state for a gentleman. Yeah, thanks to all the hustlers, and most importantly, you, the customer. Rock boys in the building tonight. Oh, what a feeling I'm feeling life. You don't even gotta bring your paper out. We the dope boys of the year. Drinks is on the house. The rock boys in the building tonight. Look at how I'm chilling, I'm killing this ice. You don't even gotta bring your purses out. We the dope boys of the year. Drinks is on the house.
We in the house.
Let your hair down, baby.
Back
I just
again,
hit a score.
Picking
your place on the planet. Pick a shawl. Take what the fall is bigger than figure more. Cause they forgot to account what I did with the fraud.
Welcome to 2024, my nigga.
Pick the
here, we
pick
made
a weekend for freaking for figure falls. I
think
the frauds never hit a lick before. So they don't know the feeling when them things get across. Put your hand out the window. Feel a force. Feel a posh. Hit the frost. Ice cold. Shoes got no flaws. Drop got no top.
Hopefully you still doing your New Year's resolution.
Think OJ. I get away with murder when I sling yay. Hebron got less steps than Britney. That means it ain't stepped on, dig me. The rock boys in the building tonight. Oh, what a
hey,
feeling
sound
I'm
check.
Feeling
one, two,
like.
One, two.
You don't
check,
even
check.
Gotta bring your paper
check,
out.
Check.
You don't
yo, yo, yo.
Drinks is on the house. The rock boys in the building tonight. Look at how I'm chilling, I'm killing this ice. You don't even gotta bring your purses out. We the dope boys of the year. Drinks is on the house. Rare Porsches, rare portraits, rare guns if you dare come near
check,
the fortress.
Check.
This apple
check,
sauce
check.
Is from the apple orchard.
Check, check. Can you hear me no names?
Which means I get it from the crown. Which means you get
I can't
it
hear
I'm
myself,
around.
But it's cool.
Rich
as long as y'all can hear me.
Black bar mitzvahs.
Might sound a little deaf today.
Celebration bitches. Naheim. I wish for you 100 years of success, but it's my time. Cheers, toast to crime. Number one D-boy, shame the
remember,
the rock boys in the building tonight.
Share, share,
oh,
share, everywhere.
You don't even gotta bring your paper out. We the
this is the year of monetization, so we need everybody's help. You listening to us, you enjoy the show, share it with a friend, share it with somebody. Give them a gift of entertainment this year.
Gotta say that.
The rock boys in the building tonight.
Yeah.
Oh, what a feeling I'm feeling life.
Yeah.
You don't even gotta bring your paper out. We the dope boys of the year. Drinks is on the house. The rock boys in the building tonight. Look at how I'm chilling, I'm killing this ice. You don't even gotta bring your purses out. We the dope boys of the year. Drinks is on the house.
Horns.
Let that ride out.
Gotta let that ride out.
Bring your horns back. Yeah. This is black superhero music right here, baby.
Woo.
American gangster. Taking flight. Coming to a town near you. As soon as I touch down, I just want y'all to start playing the horns. Like.
Is this Just Blaze?
Justin Blaze.
Justin Jefferson Blaze.
Shout out to Justin Blaze. That's a classic. Shout out my nigga Hov.
Horns!
Got you. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Silence is okay. Just like doing your dance in church is okay.
Yeah. Can you turn that up over there?
Okay. I don't know.
That's silly.
They gotta be low anyway because you gotta talk.
They about to go up. Hey, welcome back to the greatest podcast in the entire universe and all multiverses.
You gotta say that.
I hope y'all simulation been treating you well. I know mine has. How your simulation been treating you, G?
My simulation been simulating, but God is good.
No name. Simulation great.
Bebop.
Hey. Hey, resuscitation season, niggas. We back again. You know what I mean? 2024. January. What is it? The 8th?
Yep.
January the 8th, 2024. The year of monetization. Make sure y'all sharing. Make sure you caring. Make sure you ain't a caring. And it's currently 36 degrees. It's cold. Our season over with. It's fine.
Oh, God.
We'll talk about it. It's cool.
We don't have to.
Niggas still representing.
Always. Who they?
Yes. I got a list of baddies that's over 40 years old. I'm gonna call them out and see if y'all agree with this list or not.
Okay.
You know, we getting up there.
Boy.
You know, our palate is being expanded. You feel me?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's changing. You know, tricks are for kids. You know, we don't eat cereal now. We having oatmeal. All right. Okay, y'all got to tell me who this bitch is. Sorry, excuse my language.
Gypsy Rose.
Yeah. All right, so I waited purposely. I've been seeing her everywhere. I was like, who's this Gypsy Rose? I ain't want to hear a story. I was like, my niggas going to know.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all got to give me a hit. Explain what's going on.
Trust me.
Let me know if it's some conspiracy to it. You know Gypsy Rose?
No.
Okay, yeah, he with me then. We in school, nigga.
Y'all ain't telling me how to do a Gypsy Rose breakdown.
Hey, it's all good, bro. On the fly. Oh, my God. Never mind. Did y'all see that door fly off that pair of planes?
Oh, hell no.
Hey, 2024. Early.
Crazy.
The only red Stanley Cup I got. I need a marker so I can write Stanley on this bitch. Let us know if y'all got y'all Stanley. Shout out to Stanley. Whoever fuck Stanley is. Hey, Draymond Green back. Hey, who we gonna choke next? And then we got a message from a beautiful black sister we're gonna share with y'all today. But make sure y'all stay tuned. Make sure y'all sharing. Make sure you got your drink. Get your communion juice, all the above. We everywhere. YouTube, Facebook, Twitter.
We ain't talk about
WhatsApp.
Money Mike?
Of course.
I am my boy, Damon.
Cincinnati Katt, Cincinnati Jersey.
You well.
Yeah, of course. And Uncle Shannon. Represent. And we back. We glad to have you back. Hopefully y'all had a good end to your 23 and you coming into the 24 real nicely.
You gotta say that.
Real nicely.
Oh yeah.
It's that one part of the show.
It's 2024.
It's that one part.
The first edition.
Uh-oh.
Of Who Is Such and Such. I go by the world famous DJ Such and Such. Me and the guys made it to 2024 year of monetization. Yum yum. Gotta say that. I got my nigga No Name here. I got my nigga Infinitely Zay here.
That's a figure.
And I'm 1,000% sure that the bars are here.
2024.
You gotta say that. What we doing, y'all?
We got bring in the new year.
Yeah. I like that vibe. Drinks in the air, Zay. Drinks in the air.
I like it. Let's go. Created in his likeness. I think I'm a fingerprint to the likeness of touchdown on earth, then he took above, took on over, now he's a dove, it's all love. Spread my wings and I fly, even if I die, you gon' remember the reminiscent, evanescent, the presence. I'm still in it. Never getting evicted, I'm in it, I'm living. Down deep in it, mineral, diamond in it, and she's gifted. So I gift her with a bling bling. When I'm around your city, catch me in that expedition. Expedited, on site like I'm UPSing. Get it to me quick, baby. Trying to take you down top to the low, baby. You know that's balance. Yeah, no drama, but she like a little toxicity in my city. When she pull up on me, pull up in the EV Hummer, pussy humming. Not in a bad way though, no sour smiles. Fresh bouquet though, spray me, baby. Like that thing on the clown collar. Woo! Water me. I deserve it. You deserve it. Driver, please roll up them curtains.
Gotta say that.
I'm dedicated. Had to put a penance in it. And I'ma throw a TD. When I see the man clear, I'ma throw like penance in it. And I'ma strike striker. Like I want a pennant in it. I'm a writer, like I'll put a hand pennies in it. And y'all already know though, it's the 2-4. I'm around like Kobo, gotta see the pen. I'ma shoot it, yeah, Kobe, cause it's 3 going. You know I'ma lay my baptism on them like I did CP3. Nah, I'ma baptize them like Bron did PG13. I'm hearing it, and I'm feeling it. Hate it when a bitch take her time. I said, let me swim in it. Yeah. She just hard headed. Bring that line back. Yeah. Been through there. Like the running back.
Yeah. We in the 2-4. You heard what my nigga said. Ain't nothing changed but the money.
Running back.
Yeah. Who the fuck is such and such? Got no name. Got Zay. And I was correct, nigga. The bars is still here to stay.
Yeah.
Yeah. In there, put the horn, get the orchestra. Yeah, this the yeah mono with the monos. I'm here with my Lucianos.
Yeah,
and we gonna spend that Gucciano trying to get bread. Call me Breadiano, and they wonder why. They wonder why my bread be stacking up like Wonder guy. I'm a smart guy, but I've been there. Hair like a genius, bread. I've been there.
Yeah.
I told my boys, I'm just trying to make the waves, make waves like Percy Jackson. I've been watching Percy Jackson, and the way the shorty Percy gon' perch the Jackson.
Yeah.
I love the way that you feeling, my. She says she wanna feel the pie.
Yeah.
Pie, pop, pop, pie. I said this John gon' go pop, pop, pie, like.
She want me that pie like 314. Want that pie like, give it to me. Love you like a fat kid, love cake. But I do be chasing on that green. Yeah. I be where you are, baby. No matter where you are, baby. Put up the green screen. Yeah. Tune me in, baby. Get me right there. No static, no. Break up in the frequency, frequently trying to freak with her freak Nick scene. In the backyard, it's like 40 acres. We just be fucking in the middle of them acres.
Yeah.
The babies where they make up. In the city where we cake up. Yeah. Back at home where I make up. Like, baby, I ain't even do that now. I fuck the makeup up. Little mama, I love you. You know I do. You know we want a court. You know I cut the cord. You know I'm there, even when it's sore.
Big body, big Bobby, call me the big farmer. I'ma just get that green, I'm a black farmer.
Yeah.
In jail like black farmers. You get a freedom like range, I'm a harmer. Just buzzing like a hammer. The bitch got a box body like a hammer.
Woo.
But her throat go crazy. That's why I changed her name in my phone to the Hummer.
Ooh. She's a gas guzzler.
Ooh. Got throat like Komodo. One swallow, I swear this bitch is amphibious. I'm in that shit dip. Oh shit, let me quit.
The beat dip.
Dip or be dipped.
That's the quick tip.
Who the fuck is such and such?
Slip, slip. Love a nasty bitch with nip slips.
Got no name. We got Zay here in the 2-4, nigga. You already know.
2-4 for sure. Welcome all to the living testimony of some real player shit and some things not so player. But that's why we're here. Safe place for men to congregate and say how we feel. Not always right, but who's to say we're wrong? Put down ye stones and judge ye not. Women, you are always welcome, even in 2024. We adore you. And most of what we're going to talk about may or may not be educational to you. But as always, feel free to chime in, cash app in, Zelle in. I think they got some new shit. You can Apple Pay us. Uh-huh. All people come as you are, but enter these gates with praise. Because if you're just plain old toxic, we do reserve the right to rebuke you.
Goodbye.
And, well, remember, brethren, these streets are really on demon time.
You gotta say that.
And, well, we're just trying to lessen that temptation a little bit so you don't get played by a little.
Beep.
That's a fact. Grab your favorite communion juice. Got mine's. Break bread with your deacon board. I'm your host, Infinitely Zay. We got G in the circle.
Downtown G Brown, a.k.a. DJ Such and Such, a.k.a. Mr. Gotta Say That, a.k.a. R.I.P. Uncle Lou, a.k.a. It's the 2-4, what we gonna do? Yum, yum.
That's a fact. We got No Name Jay in the circle.
Blessed and highly favored, you feel me?
I feel that.
Hey.
And this is the Player Circle Bible Study class. Class is now in session.
And just know when the cameras cut and we say that's it, we still gonna be on some player shit. Gotta say that. We here, nigga. We made it.
We are in the year of 2024, nigga.
The 2-4.
Nigga, I remember when it was just a Y2K bug.
That's crazy. That was 24 years ago.
That's crazy. 2000, bro. What was y'all doing in 2000?
Shit, I was in Cali.
What's that, high school year?
I was either a
freshman.
Freshman or an eighth grader. Nah.
Was it
high? It was eighth grade.
I think it was eighth grade. Yeah,
2000 was eighth grade. That's crazy. Yeah, well, hey, we made it. 2024, two decades in. Another thing that be happening to me, because I'm getting older and everything, like, you ever think of something, and then you be like, yeah, but then you be like, man, that was 20 years ago.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? You be like, dang, that was 20 years ago. That's a memory that I got right now. Mm-hmm. It's a 20-year-old memory. Mm-hmm. When you was younger, you know what I mean? You be like, you try to think of some shit happened. It'd be like 3 years ago. That was a memory. Man, 5 years ago in eighth grade, you know what I'm saying? You a junior. But eighth grade was a long ways away.
Damn. Eighth grade.
Now high school is a long ways away from us.
Mm-hmm. Was y'all still virgins in eighth grade?
Was not a virgin.
I think that's when I lost it.
Nah. I lost my virginity in eighth grade, but it was whack. So I don't count it.
I got some head in eighth grade.
Yeah, I don't count
it. I ain't lose my virginity till my sophomore year.
Oh, good for you.
Yeah, I waited.
The upstanding sentence.
Eighth grade. I could have lost it. I ain't gonna never forget, bro. It was this Mexican girl and her boyfriend. And they asked me to run a train. I was like,
what?
I'm not even lying to you.
How old was they, nigga?
They was in eighth grade too, nigga.
Man, they was thinking different. You said you was in Cali?
Yup.
Oh yeah, he was in
Cali. I was shook too. I remember it was and this she used to love me, nigga.
We weren't doing that in Ohio yet.
Trains in the eighth
grade. Yeah, they was like, wow. We about to go behind the building. I was like, nah, I gotta go to basketball practice. That's crazy. That'd have been a wild ass way
to trains was around 7th, 8th grade. They were happening for sure. But like for a nigga that be ask you to be on some cuckold shit, like
basically
fuck my girl, bro, while I watch. That's wild.
And he was so weird too. I forgot his name though. Yeah. He was Mexican and she was Mexican too, I guess.
Man, be careful out there. These demon time. Boy. That was 24 years ago. Imagine what they own now.
Nigga.
Hey, keep yourself prayed up and stayed up.
Man.
You know what I mean? How y'all doing, though? How y'all been, man? What's going on? We in 24. How you feeling? Man, what's the vibe?
I ain't gonna lie to you,
what's
bro.
The vibe?
I'm just here right now. I'm here.
Hey, Hey, I'm. You know what? I'm glad you're here, my nigga.
I'm just here.
Hey, I'm glad you're here, my nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Pause.
Yeah. They about to just see hands. Man, but everybody good, though?
Yeah, man.
About up and up. You too, no name. You good?
Yeah, man. Been grinding, you know. Finally got up on some a little, you know, a little coin. So I ordered, or I hired like an editor.
Nice.
Finished editing, cuffed a little bit.
Okay, so, man.
Cause I was just dragging, you know what I mean.
For so sure. It's like editing is the,
yeah,
that should be fucking us up every year.
You said for cuff,
yeah, for cuff. So we about to get these episodes.
Shout out to Cuff the Curve, nigga. Tap in the merch available. Is available now?
It's available now.
Nah, where my link at, bro?
Hey, where my gotta say that T-shirt, bro?
That's y'all link.
It's both on there.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Promotional.
You ain't even look at. You know?
I did look.
That's why.
It was just her.
That's why I should have been a host. He should have been dating motherfuckers.
First of all, I did date motherfuckers, I dated a motherfucker for you, nigga.
Chill.
Last minute, I had to come through because infinitely Zay.
That's why I got fired. No name was like, you ain't showing for a date. Fuck it. That's what really happened.
Damn, talk about it. Is that what really happened?
Nah.
Damn.
I ain't really. No, hell no.
Damn.
That probably did, I'm sure.
No, he was supposed to be on.
Nah, but I just, you know what I'm saying? Shit.
I had somebody else for him, though. But then, I think he was about to come, but then Shorty, she lived in Columbus or something, so when I canceled that first.
Yeah.
And then you said you was about to go on, then she said she couldn't do it no more. So.
Yeah.
Nah, he was going to show up.
I show up. Hey, we showed up.
Show up and show out.
You feel me? We showed up, bro. Yeah. 2023, we showed up. Would you say that?
Gotta say that.
Did you show up?
For sure. All right.
I showed up. I hope everybody out there listening showed up. Also, don't be so hard on yourself. I had to sit back and, you know, just in my meditation, I just felt like God was like, man, you just be way too hard on yourself.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And then it ain't even hard. Like, you know, when most people say that, it's almost like a self-loathing thing, right? Like, I don't need to be hard on myself. Like, you know, but for real, it's more so like, pay attention and be aware of the blessings that you had. And I'm speaking in past tense for 23. So the blessings that you had in 23. Like, nigga, I added up what I made in 2022 and what I made in 23, my nigga.
Blessed.
Blessed. Hey. You feel me? But I'm in it, though. I'm looking like, fuck. You know what I mean? Don't get me wrong. You know what I'm saying? We still building. You know what I mean? Facts. But at the same time, it was like, damn, like if I was just more aware, I probably would have made better investments. You know what I mean? Like better investments that year. Or sometimes you only make a certain type of money, so it ain't as fluid as you wanted it to be. So you hold on to it a little longer. You know, scared money don't make no money. That's a real thing, right? When I added it up, I was like, damn. That's a... You know, such and such of dollars that could have been circulating
out,
a different way. No.
Them
you know.
7-0.
It's at least 6-0 the way he talking.
Chill.
My nigga in the M Club, talk that shit, Zay.
I need to be. Pray for me.
Right outside of Billy.
Put me in there, nigga.
The first million is the hardest to get.
That's what they say, bro. That's what they say. I hope y'all support y'all crew, like my crew support me.
That's a fact.
You know what I'm saying? I know I got a slick trick for y'all. If y'all see y'all nigga doing something slick under somebody's like post or something, he in there like, Shorty, you fly, just go under his post and be like, hey, bro, thanks for that $200,000 you let me borrow.
That's fire.
You feel me? I saw somebody did that. I think it was like Chloe Bailey, like, or somebody. It was like some random nigga with like 400 followers. It was like, damn, baby, like, man, you bad, blah, blah, blah. Like, and then somebody went over there, like, hey, bro, I really appreciate that $2 million you let me have. I was like, oh, these niggas perfect.
No problem, so, man. Anytime.
Hey, if y'all ain't support y'all niggas like that in 2024, man,
that's love.
Just let them niggas leave, bro. Let them niggas be, man.
That's love.
Who usually start? I'm
gonna tell you who ain't what.
Nah, go ahead, go ahead.
Who's the opposite of supporting niggas?
What?
Your nigga Katt Williams.
Oh man,
that nigga told it all.
Hey, shout out to Katt in the Hat, man.
Cincinnati's finest.
Cincinnati Katt, Cincinnati jersey. Yeah. But I know Let's just silence the room for a second.
Okay.
You want crazy?
I know one cat that ain't gonna be in the playoffs. Damn.
Oh man.
It's a Bengal cat. We gotta say it. We gotta get it out the way.
He's excited.
We gotta get it out the way.
Ain't nothing to get out the way, man. We gonna see y'all next season, nigga. We got a bottom four schedule. We got a top 20 pick.
Mm-hmm. We about to go crazy.
Joe Shiesty on the full. This nigga better be there on the beginning of training camp, nigga. Yeah. He better not fucking get hurt.
Yeah.
And you know what happened the last time he had a season-ending injury. We went to the Super Bowl.
There we go.
But this time it's going to be different because we're going to win that motherfucker.
That's a fact, man. Yes, that's a fact. Yes, shout out to the Cincinnati Bengals, man.
Yeah, who that?
You know, the season is what it was. I do want to say this, bro. I was paying attention because I know you're a strong advocate of saying Zach Taylor is not a good coach. And he is not.
I was about to say, I hope you ain't come here to debate me on that, nigga.
He's about to go. Like, let's go. I've been waiting for this.
Right.
Fuck Zach Taylor. Nah, I ain't saying it like that.
No, fuck Zach Taylor. You
for sure.
Nigga, look at Mike Tomlin.
Looking at other teams that.
Look at Mike Tomlin, nigga.
What's the other team that had like two rookie quarterbacks and.
Fucking Cleveland. Well, Cleveland ain't did get
I think that nigga up for like coach of the year.
CJ Stroud.
Yeah.
Like, bruh.
We could that's what really made me like see. I was like, damn, it's coaching, bro. Without talent, he's not winning. You've been saying that all season, bro. So,
he's a front runner, bro.
So, shout out to you, my nigga.
Yeah, shout out to my nigga Joe Mixon. Hit that incentive.
Yeah,
he was balling.
Yeah, he was balling. He wanted to show out.
Joe went down.
I do like how the teams do that though. Like when players got like incentives, because I seen it was at least six incentives that I seen him. For the touchdowns. Was it 1,000 yards? Or it was two touchdowns or something. He needed two touchdowns. Mm-hmm. I know Jadeveon Clowney hit his incentive.
Yeah, those people getting paid.
Cleveland actually restructured Flacco's contract so that he can get an incentive. His incentive was like for each game he played or something. Mm. But
since it was just sitting on the couch a couple months ago.
Yeah, but since he got him to the playoffs – and had to sit. We didn't have to sit, but like they restructured, so he got his incentive.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I know Chris Jones got a $1.2 million incentive.
That's crazy.
Shout out to incentives.
Yeah.
Speaking of incentives, I know one thing.
What?
If you use PCBS at brewstees.com, you get 10% off your merchandise.
That's a hell of an incentive right there.
You feel me?
Brews Tees. Hold on. Did they change the website on there? Or do I got to cut that nigga
It's brewstees.com now.
Is it?
Yep. Just straight to the point.
Straight down.
My nigga upgraded. Shout out to our 10%, bro.
Shout out to our.
AB.
We've been making them money.
We done took y'all up, B. Nah.
Brews Tees. Check them out on Instagram, brews.tees. Fully customizable or pre-designed apparel. Tees, hoodies, pants, shorts, socks, underwear, hats, swimsuits, tracksuits, cups. And they specialize in vinyl. That's brews.tees on Instagram, brewstees.com, or you can go brewstees.square.site and it'll take you to the new site.
Good shit, my nigga.
Shout out to our sponsor, man. Shout out to Black Women.
We always love the Black Women.
Blackwomen.com. I don't know what that's going to take you to, but.
My nigga, no name just filled it up like in a Rubik's Cube. Like, where you going, bro? Hey, man, shout out to another year, though, for real.
For
sure. Yeah, sad about the Bengals. Yeah, I mean, shit, we on Cincinnati shit. Let's go ahead.
Yeah.
All right. I mean, obviously the Katt Williams thing is probably old now. Everybody done seen it. Everybody and their mama watched it. That's another thing. People who I ain't even suspect to be like, hey, you seen the Katt Williams thing? I'm like, what? How you know about it? So, I don't know. I mean, hey, do y'all think he told the truth on everything? Was it more entertainment?
He had to, bro. The way he was running in that damn basketball court.
That nigga said he run a sub-4.3, nigga. I say, what?
Man, that basketball court only like 36 yards or something like that.
I think
he was booking, though.
I think it was like certain points where I could tell he was telling the truth.
Yeah.
But like when that nigga said he read 3,000 books in a year, nigga, I said, I started thinking, like, damn, what this nigga reading? Kitty books? Like, you know, little four-page books and shit?
probably, that's probably what it, that's a book, nigga.
Nigga, how many books, that's what that's, 10 books a day, nigga?
I don't know.
Well, 365 days, it's probably like a little bit under 10 books a day.
That nigga was reading. Dick went over to Jane. Jane, y'all remember Dick, Jane, and Sally?
Nah, bro. No. Niggas always try to bring other motherfuckers in that shit. Y'all remember that?
Hey, that was
no, I do not.
That was a special class I was in. It was that Liquor Heights Elementary. I used to take you out of class if you need help learning how to read better.
And that was the book they told you to read?
That was the characters in there. It was Dick, Jane, and Sally. And they used to do stuff like, they used to like go help a kid like cross the street or some weird shit.
Man, some Epstein shit.
Maybe.
All right, quick
pivot. Was you on that list?
Nah, quick pivot. What was y'all? So, contrary to belief, like, I'm smart as fuck, but I was never a reader. Mm-hmm. Like, I could probably tell you 4 or 5 books that I done read in my whole life.
Right.
What was one of y'all favorite books when y'all was little?
When we was little?
Or, yeah, when we was little, because I know y'all needs to be reading, like, the 48 Laws of Power.
The Bernstein Bears?
Okay.
Is that like a chapter book?
That was a hit.
Or the Boxcar Kids?
I remember them.
Judy Blume.
I want hip to that. My favorite book was Tears of a Tiger, nigga.
Did it make you cry?
I don't know.
You read that?
No.
Y'all ever read Forged by Fire?
Nope.
It's about, what's her name? I can't forget her name. But she from Cincinnati.
Nah.
Yeah, we ain't read here. Next topic.
Non-read talk.
Hey, we putting up. We about to edit that out. So.
Nah, I was
shout
thinking.
Out the books.
It was either a Huckleberry Finn. That story was crazy.
They was saying nigger in there a lot.
To kill him.
When they saying nigger in there a lot?
Bruh, you got to keep me on track because that took me somewhere
else. Take off. I know what you about to do. Go ahead.
Did y'all see the Dave Chappelle?
Yeah. Oh, speaking of that, so y'all know we saw him live in Chicago. Mm-hmm. It was the same show pretty much. That's what he did. That everything was pretty much the same. Actually, verbatim, that was the show he did. like that was, but it was still good to watch. Like, you know, my memory ain't good anyway, so it ain't like I remembered it. And then it's a lot of other stuff you got to do when you're there, like putting your phone in the pouch and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? It just kind of take away from. I actually enjoyed it more sitting at home watching it, than being there live. But I mean, yeah, he went in on them handicapped people, bro. He's definitely a GOAT, bro. Like,
for sure.
I heard people saying, you know, they tired of hearing them talk about the same thing and blah, 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 you know. Like, hey, you got to chuckle out of me.
That shit was funny, and nigga.
Got some money out of me, too, so. Shout out to Dave Chappelle, man. But, yeah, Huckleberry Finn, that's why I knew you was about to talk about that nigga.
You should have took me there, bro. All right, back to Katt Williams. Was that nigga lying or not?
Hey, Katt is a wild man. That's all I can say, man. But that nigga in Cincinnati, nigga, for sure.
Yeah, he went up there. And he went up there on his bullshit. He already knew what he was on.
Started off the tip.
That's Adrian Bronner's uncle. What y'all thought?
It's real.
We can start whatever we want on this podcast, G. We can say whatever we want. Yes, Adrian Bronner's.
I believe it, though.
You feel me? Them niggas act like Cincinnati niggas, bro. Every time on some yak, bro. Don't give no Cincinnati nigga anything dark.
That's crazy.
Do you think Shannon was surprised, like how he was going crazy?
Nah, Shannon, man.
Or do you think it was like some kind of pre-production where he was like,
nah, Shannon wasn't ready for that shit. Yeah, he didn't know what was going on.
Yeah, he was surprised. That's why. Like at the end of it, he started throwing random shit. Like, so what you think about Jonathan Majors?
It got away from me.
He was like, shit, he gonna talk about every topic. I might have clip after clip to use because this nigga going crazy.
Yeah.
Like, what you think about global warming, nigga?
They got 27 million views in 3 days. Bro.
That's crazy. They took it down.
What? Who?
It wasn't something. So I seen somebody say they took it down.
Damn.
Nah. They must have got a cease and desist.
Yeah,
nigga.
That's crazy. They took that down. A lot of people was hating on Shannon, like, you know, saying he ain't doing a good job as an interviewer.
Nigga, what?
You ain't had to say shit.
At all.
Like, people just be hating because he's just coming in and he's just doing his own thing and now he got a hit. Like, I think they had a list of, damn, I thought I had it. But, like, a list of the most viral. It was up there with, like, Birdman. Everybody else was like 10 million below. This was number one for sure. Like,
nigga, this had 35 million.
That's crazy.
In 5 days.
Bro, that shit gonna be in 100 million by next year, bro. People gonna watch. That was a comedy special, bro.
Yeah.
That was a comedy special, nigga.
That's crazy.
That was what people wanna see, bro. You feel me? Like, really, that's where you want to come act up. That's why he got what he got. Everybody else come on there, oh, like Cedric Entertainer, let's have an interview, ask me about my family life. And, nah, this nigga Kes said, how you doing? And went straight to it.
And another thing.
And another thing.
Who all he shot at? He shot at Sid. Yeah. Steve. Nigga. But he was going in on Ricky Smiley.
He shot at Jonathan Majors.
Oh, my God. Hey, I knew it was something, and when they tried to tell me this African-looking nigga, what did he say? This slave-looking nigga was attractive or some shit.
He said, if he attractive, I'm attractive. I'm sitting there like, yeah, he right. Yeah, they definitely tried to say that was a handsome black man.
Damn.
Man, I saw somebody post a comment, bro. You know, he was, Jonathan Majors been on his big Coretta Scott shit, right?
Yeah.
So, I guess in the clip they asked him about that because he did an interview. They asked him, like, so, why was you, telling her? He was like, I'm just trying to, that's who I'm trying to be. So that's the type of woman I want in my life, basically what he said. And I scrolled down to the comments. Somebody was like, man, I ain't never seen a nigga have a civil rights fetish. I said, bro, that's crazy. Shout out to Coretta Scott.
Right.
And black women.
That's crazy. He said Luda had an ugly wife.
Bro, he said all the dudes got light-skinned, square-headed women, bro.
Did y'all see that picture?
Yeah, it was real. I'm like,
and then they had another one, all of them in dresses, nigga. I was like,
Yeah. And they showed, they did show a few, I think it was said that had stole some material.
Oh yeah, I seen that.
They saw that. I think it was the whole Mr. Y'all think his hair was a man unit?
I been heard that though.
For real?
Yeah.
Damn, they had man units in the '90s.
Yeah, I been heard that.
That's big money then.
It is. A I just started hearing perfect. About
man units. Like, yeah, it's straight. Steve Harvey headline was like, you can go into the barbershop, like, give me the Steve.
Uh-huh.
And they knew what you was talking about. That was straight edge, boy.
But I seen somebody post like, it's real, because why would he go from that kind of hair to bald headed, like,
bald more suave. But I like Steve, man. I'm a fan of Steve. You know what I'm saying? I'm a fan of Steve. DL Hughley, I don't really care about like that.
Nah, that nigga funny.
Yeah, he's definitely funny, but I'm saying like I don't follow him. Like I'm saying right now, I see Steve Harvey, I'm like, okay, cool. Like,
DL Hughley funnier than
I
Steve
fuck
Harvey
with Steve though. Harvey. Funny is different. I mean, I'm just saying, in general. Person,
yeah.
Yeah, like in general, like, okay, I fuck with Steve Harvey. I fuck what he's doing. I fuck with what he's doing. And I see the success he got going on, right?
Not after that. Think like a man bullshit.
What you mean?
I mean, the movie's cool, but the movement.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, he did have us on some other shit for a while, didn't he?
It was hard to get something quick.
Yeah, it was.
The best thing that happened to him was Family Feud, nigga. That's his comedy, nigga.
Family Feud, and then I feel like it's one more, and his radio show. You know what I'm saying? He's
still. I've never heard Steve Harvey.
I haven't either, but I'm just saying, like he moving, he get shit. Yeah. Like, I'm sure he still do the Miss America thing too, right? Or did they fire him for getting it wrong?
I think they moved on.
They moved on. My nigga professional. They moved on.
They moved on.
Hey, you come in the office like, oh, we're moving on. HR has spoken. All right. Man, 2023 was a wild motherfucking year.
Man.
I got this little thing right here. I'm going to pull it up. Let me see. I got to get my notes right. Man, I thought I had it.
Yeah, I got y'all favorite thing of the year that happened to y'all.
Favorite thing of the year?
Yeah, 2023.
What you mean?
What's your favorite moment in your life?
Oh, my daughter's birth, for sure. That's big. I think that was a good, that was a big moment. You know what I'm saying? I think that kind of just, it was a lot of good little moments here and there, but that catapulted a new era of my life, for sure. So, shout out to that.
That's big.
I say, I got like three things. So, like my job's contract getting pushed through.
Facts.
That's big, big money.
Meeting my girl.
Facts.
Big money.
And what was the third one?
Getting some other hoes,
just making it through 2023.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, facts.
What's yours?
That's a good thing. I don't even know. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But
it's only 8 days in.
It felt like a build year. You know what I mean? And this year, definitely that year of monetization.
That's a fact.
Off the build.
Yep.
So, nah, it definitely was a good little year.
Yep. Shout out to 23. We had to go through 23 to get to 24.
Uh-huh.
Unless we was in 22 and just skipped. That's a wild simulation.
Might have.
And if you did skip 23, you would have missed all this shit. Last year, January, Christian Rock got pregnant. That was big news. February last year, them big ass red boots was hopping, and Rihanna was pregnant. March, what is this? Oh, Ja Morant. That old thing.
Oh, damn.
Pew, pew.
April, Angela Reese with the whole, you know,
okay,
blah, 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 during the championship was a big thing. May, Usher was killing that shit.
Pause.
Why?
Usher was killing that shit?
Oh, yeah. Pause. All right.
May, all of May, Usher was killing that shit. What happened in June, nigga? Shit.
We was in healing.
Hey, yo.
All right, I got to pause myself. All right. It got Ja Morant in here again. I don't know what he did in May, too. He just kept
it's another gun. Around. Remember that nigga spent like twice for guns, nigga?
Hey, that nigga goofy. Usher was wilding out. Beyonce went on tour in May. May was big. June. Is that Lizzo?
Yeah, she. When she had the thing about.
Nah, that ain't Lizzo. That ain't Lizzo. I don't know who that is. I don't know what that's about. July. Usher, Keke Palmer. That was wild.
Yeah. That's crazy.
August. Guilty, Tory Lanez. The Alabama Tea Party.
Oh, yeah.
All right. So at the end of this, y'all got to tell me what was the most viral, viral or the one that stood out to the most to you.
Uh-huh.
What is that? September. Look at September with that. You know that? What is it?
That's Krishan when she was in the thing with her baby.
Oh.
With her baby head back. I don't know.
Hey, that's wild, bro. All right. Krishan made it twice. October, Jada. Hey, she took over October.
That's crazy.
November, little nigga was standing on business. Yeah. That boy was standing on business. Cassie and Diddy. That was November. And then December, Jonathan Majors found guilty. What was the craziest month? What was the most viral month of 23 for y'all? What y'all vote?
I don't know if it's necessarily a month, but I think the Jonathan Majors thing was like.
Yeah, he was over here. You can see his.
Like picture. One of the biggest things of the year.
Yeah.
And definitely Tory.
Yeah. I think the Alabama Tea Party, bro.
I think that might have been the most viral moment.
Yeah, I think that was like the. That's the one that's going to be remembered.
Yeah, I think.
From 23 for sure. Like. You know what I mean?
Yeah, as far as viral, I think that was the most. Because, like, we going to hear about the celebrities anyway.
Yeah.
Like, that's something that just happened. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. That damn near might be history one day, so.
Yeah, that's history already.
Yeah.
They're going to turn it into a movie for sure.
That'd be crazy. All the everything leading up. Some white people getting drunk. Doing wild shit on the boat. Like, woo! Going to show niggas on the back smoking weed on the little thing.
My nigga swam to the fight.
Yeah.
Said, fuck it.
Who gonna play him?
I'll probably do some shit like that though. I ain't gonna lie. If I see a nigga getting jumped.
Starring Trevor Jackson. He gonna be the swimmer, dude.
I'll be the swimmer, nigga. I told you my first fight, nigga, when I got jumped, trying to help a nigga get because he that nigga white boy punched the shit out of me.
Jumped trying to help somebody that's fucked up.
I ain't getting jumped. He was getting jumped. So I'm like, bro, I can't let my nigga get jumped. I don't even know this nigga like that, but fuck it.
But fuck it. Yeah.
I jumped to that motherfucker. Pow.
Yeah, no, I think all that's right. Just like a nigga's like somebody you click with. I ain't gonna say just cause you know somebody, like, but yeah. You probably click with him. Like, you see a nigga getting jumped, you definitely gonna try to go over there and see what's going on first. I ain't gonna say you gonna jump right in.
Let me see what's going on. Let me assess.
You gonna wanna see what's going on first. You feel me? Cause
yeah, nigga's crazy.
You feel me? Niggas, you know, crazy. Like,
and now what did you do to get yourself in this situation?
Right.
First of all, if I see G getting jumped, bro, or I see No Day getting jumped, I'm gonna jump in straight up.
Oh yeah, ain't no questions.
But there's some niggas that I got around too that is, I might be like, what you do, nigga?
Turn like, out the way like shit.
They would call you. What happened?
Like, hello?
Man, I ain't even seen.
Damn, they jumped you, bro.
run in when it's over. Like, bro, I just got
I had you, bro. Them niggas scared.
Hey, how many niggas y'all know that did that? I was there, bro. I was in there.
I was about to.
I was in there. I was going to hit him with the, you know what I'm saying?
But then, I remember I was getting jumped, nigga.
And the police came.
I was in D.C., nigga, and I got jumped. Well, it was like a fight, and then these niggas caught up to me later. I was on the ground getting stumped out and looked at a nigga that I thought was my friend standing there looking like.
Shut the fuck up.
I swear to God.
He said it looked like it was that nigga.
No, I looked at him, and I know it was him.
Oh, no.
That nigga was just looking like.
Yeah, you ain't never hang with that nigga again, huh? Nigga.
You know the little fat boy in the Burger King where he be like, man, that's how that nigga looked at me, bro.
Nah, fuck that, bro. He got to go.
Said, nigga, hell.
You ever been jumped before, don't
they? I ain't never been jumped. Nah.
I've been jumped twice.
I got jumped in Cleveland one time. Well, I ain't get jumped. I ran. I ain't gonna lie. I ran for my life.
I tried to run, nigga.
I ran for my life. I hit the little nigga in the way, and I got. I ran up the middle of the street, nigga. Nigga, I dropped my. I had a backpack. I had everything I had. I just let it go. You know what I mean? I don't mean to take away from the comedic part of it, but like the day before, these same niggas had a nigga on the ground, like bleeding to death because they shot this nigga. Like, these were the same niggas. Like, I'm like, yeah.
Oh, no, for sure.
We ain't fucking with it. We out of here.
Get the fuck on up out of there,
man. I blacked out on the side of a shed. Everything, like, I was throwing up and shit.
I threw up after I got jumped too, nigga.
Nigga, I was running so hard, I threw up. Like, it was, I was running for my life, bro. I was running up the middle of the street, nigga. Like, cars was going this way, that way. I'm just running up the middle. Them niggas still chasing me. Like, I had some burners on me.
I jumped in a random girl car, bro.
See?
Like, bro, just take me up the street. It was, like, right down the street from my house, bro. Yeah,
nigga.
I got to the house and threw up like a motherfucker.
Man, I'll never forget them Denison Street niggas on the west side of Cleveland. If I ever see y'all niggas again, man, I swear to God.
Smoke, nigga. Where they at, bro? Let's go.
Like I said,
Denison Street. Hard trip, nigga. We got guns now, nigga.
We big now. But anyways, I shouldn't have been up there doing what I was doing. That's what mama said. That's what my mama said. Shouldn't have been up there doing what you was doing. You right, mama. I would have never been in this problem. All right. Who is Gypsy Rose? Who is this bee?
Gypsy Rose Blanchard.
Because I've been seeing her everywhere.
So.
I don't know who this lady.
Basically.
This porcelain.
Like her. It's a disease. Her mom had some kind of like mental disorder.
Okay.
I can't remember what it was.
Tell me this ain't the girl who like. She was acting like she was sick, so they kept drugging her.
Yeah, like her mama was telling her that she was sick.
Is that?
Yeah,
I didn't know that.
But the documentary fire, the Hulu show is fire.
What's the documentary?
The show is on Hulu. I can't. It's another documentary, but I had seen a documentary before. I seen the actual show.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that shit good.
I gotta hear.
The show is called The Act.
I've heard the story.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's who it is. Got you.
So she kind of like got fed. Like she was wheelchair bound. Like, come on, pulled all her teeth out, all type of shit.
On some placebo shit. Like.
Yeah, so.
But she was probably really giving her the real drugs, though.
Yeah. Like so, taking her to get real.
So it's fucking her up, probably. Like,
right.
Damn.
So she ended up getting this boyfriend who was fucking slow. And
is that the dude she married to that I saw her posted with?
Since nah.
She got a good dick from?
Nah. Okay. What?
Never mind. Sorry. Keep going, brother.
But basically, the dude killed her mama.
Oh,
like they came, they devised a plan to kill her mama.
Okay,
so
is he in jail?
Yeah, that nigga doing. I think he doing life.
Okay,
just because of how violent, like he killed the mama, like fucked her while she was dead. Yeah, like chopped her head off, all type of shit.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, so he doing life.
That's crazy.
Yeah, but she.
You know about this too?
I know that. I've seen it.
Is that all in a documentary?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Watch,
the show first.
Okay.
Because I think the show more cinematic. Like,
yeah.
Then watch the documentary. That's fire, nigga.
Yeah.
His brother just showed up to his game.
Yeah. Shout out to the Hardballs, right?
Nah, fuck them, nigga.
Michigan, bro. They up too. 17-3. If y'all watching the game at home on a sacred Monday with us.
Oh, yeah. Mondays are sacred.
All the males look alike. You saw their daddy?
Huh? Who's daddies?
The Harbaugh.
Oh, yeah. Yep. There you go. That's him right there.
Yeah. They whole family. All the males look. They twins, but.
They twins? I never knew
they
that.
They twins?
I believe so.
They look just alike. They might be twins.
Yeah. They look like Harbaughs. All right. The girls that are over 40, man. I'm going to go through this list, man. They some baddies, man. These some baddies, okay? And we getting up there in age, and I'm just grateful that the women don't look like what I used to imagine when I was younger and used to look at the 40-year-olds. Like, we getting closer to that number, you feel me? So it's like,
that's right.
And then I start noticing what I'm attracted to. You ever see, like, you look at, like, she'd be like 50, 60, you're like, hmm.
Miss Pack
can still get it. Miss Brenda still got that thing back there. And it sits up still. It ain't laying asleep yet.
I hit a 60-year-old before.
Shut the fuck up, nigga. You for real?
I think so.
Oh, man. Let me turn off this iPad. We about to go here, unpack this.
I think she was like 50.
Just a hypocrite. Talking about you over here. Attracted to 60-year-olds, nigga. And you did that 10 nigga, years ago, nigga. So.
10 years. Nigga, that 10-year age and that pussy is different. I can 1,000% guarantee you, nigga.
Oh, my God. What was the 60-year-old pussy like, no man?
No, I don't know. She was around there.
Shout out to my neighbors.
Oh, shit. They probably listening to
me. Go ahead.
Popcorn and shit like, come
on. Niggas, it's pretty interesting.
What's your podcast name?
It was on some off the club.
You know when that nigga start the
sentence. What you doing in the club with 60-year-olds, bro?
Come on, bro. He be at them old school parties.
It was
at, he said, I was like, what you doing for New Year's? He said, I'm going to be at this old school party.
Nah, it was at Copa. I don't know what she was doing there, but you know what I mean? She bagged me, shit.
She got you with some candy.
Man, boy. Pulled out the
strawberry joints.
She pulled out
the little butterscotch, baby.
One of them cream savers.
Creamsicles.
You want a peppermint, young man?
So it's like, that's creamy, but if you want to know what's really creamy.
No way. Shut the hell up. You freestyling right now. This nigga is freestyling. No way. All right, 1 through 10, what was the pussy like?
It was a cool little 7.5.
Okay.
Yeah.
There's some young girls that ain't got the 7.5.
Did you hit more than once?
It was like a night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, 7.5, you don't necessarily double back to 7.5. I say the 8s. 8 is when you like, all right, I'm gonna do it again.
Mm-hmm.
10, we friends for life.
Bitch, I love you.
Hey, we friends for life. No, whatever you need. Whatever you need.
She ain't give you no money or nothing.
Nah.
She co-signed on that camera, nigga.
Shit, I wish. I'm about to hit her up.
You need to, nigga.
And I beat the brakes off that motherfucker.
Oh, no.
Knocked her head by the place.
Man, she was talking. Hey, next time you see her,
she going to be in a wheelchair. You going to be wondering how she got there. Is you no. young, nigga?
Man, now she was talking cash money in the club, bro.
Man, hey, them old women, they'll say something too. You ain't never heard them. Like, let me wrap a taste with you, young.
She was fine. She had a little poker too, you know what I mean?
That's what it be. It set up well?
Yeah.
All right. Here go a list of women, bro. Let's see. All right. I'm going to just name them and I'm going to say their age. The first one. Jennifer Hudson. She's 42.
Okay.
She cool.
Taraji P. Henson. What? She 53.
See? I told you.
Okay.
Gabrielle Union.
I'm hitting.
51.
Facts.
I'm hitting.
See? I hit a Gabrielle Union.
Nia Long.
Oh, yeah. 53.
I'm hitting.
Oh, my God.
I'm wifing.
And I'm looking at these pictures while I say them, so.
Yeah.
God. At least she a daddy. Megan Good, 42.
Uh-uh. 1,000%. That's a no-brainer.
I saw her when she was on that little interview with Jonathan Majors. I was like, that young man don't know what he in for. He's a dunner. Do you know? She just looking at her eye, that's a grown-ass woman.
She coming off the pastor.
Oh, my God.
She ready to turn.
Man, what? More. She will tranquilize a young boy out here. Sanaa Lathan.
1,000%.
Oh, God. I would marry her. 52.
Let me see.
Yes, love.
Sinead. Oh, shout out to you. Eve. 45.
Yeah. Mm.
I already know who that is out the corner of my eye, nigga.
Who? Jenny Mai.
Oh, no. Nah,
I'm cool
Maya.
On Jenny Mai, bro. Maya can go, too.
Maya.
Ooh. Oh, Maya. Brandy.
1,000%.
Oh my God, Brandy.
Chocolate on
tall, long legged ass.
Sitting up in my room.
Tika Sumpler. Oh yeah.
I don't know what
that is. Name sounds so familiar. 43, but
she an actor.
She from.
Yeah, I see her.
She foine.
Hold on, bruh.
Ain't she from.
Shout out to black women. We're going to start out 2024 honoring y'all. That's what we're doing. All the black women.
We are not honoring black women.
Yes, we are.
Boston like a motherfucker.
Nah. Black women are fine.
I'm trying to bless them.
Yeah, it's a blessing. Shout out to black women. You know what I'm saying? They are Coretta Scotts. You ain't got to tell them. Oh, I don't even know who that is. I can't even say. All the Destiny's Child. Latoya Luckett, 42. Kelly Rowland, 42.
Going.
Beyonce, 42.
Going.
Michelle, 44.
Going.
I feel like sex with Michelle would be awkward. Regina Hall. Oh, look at the picture of her, too.
Yeah, it's funny.
Yeah, we'd have a good time. 53. I know her poop. Never mind. Sorry. We supposed to be here. Honor. It's 2024. And I'm halfway through my act. Okay. Nicki Minaj, 41. She get on my nerves. I ain't lying.
Her ass too fake.
Man, I always liked her. Tracy Ellis Ross.
Yeah, she always, I like her personality.
I used to watch Girlfriend. She used to have that thing back there, and she ain't never wore a bra. I was like, damn.
God damn.
Yeah, I was watching that like, what the hell? I loved it as a young son. Regina King. She can get it too. 53. Man, shout out to the black woman, man. Shout out to the beautiful. Yes, yes, Lord.
Yes. You know.
And of course, these are the stars, but we see our everyday woman looking beautiful,
yes.
Blessed, black, and highly favored. You know what I'm saying?
So you right there who listening, make sure you hit subscribe while you listening. Looking beautiful, black queen.
Yeah. I like when No Name Voice come in. It's like, roll that beautiful bean footage, nigga. Yeah, click that right there. Hell yeah. Shout out to us, man. Shout out to black women.
What's up?
Yep, shout out to y'all. All right, so there was this list. I just want to go through that. I ain't read it yet, but I'm about to read it now. A classroom list of prohibited word sayings goes viral as social media users discuss if the list is anti-black. We need a court show.
I already know it is, but go ahead.
Right.
These word sayings are prohibited in my classroom! Exclamation mark.
Is this a white person?
I'm sure. Okay. I'm sure. We'll deduce whether or not it is. All right? We'll see the list of words. There's 32 words that you are not prohibited to say in this woman's or man's classroom. I'm going to read what they said. They said, if you are caught using these words, you will write a short essay explaining why you choose to use these words in an academic setting to express yourselves. There are many ways to articulate what you need to say without using slang. Please know that using slang in an academic setting can diminish your capability to become a successful writer. More often than not, the way you speak is the way you will write. The gibberish some of you choose to use in improper English and sometimes inappropriate for an academic setting. This is an educational institution, and you will carry yourself as scholars in my classroom. I ain't gonna lie, I can see a black woman being on that too, though. So, you feel me? All right, number one. Just guess, what's the number one word you can't use in the class?
Nigga.
Bruh.
Bruh?
Yeah.
What?
Can't say bruh.
I kicked out of that class already.
He gone.
Why wouldn't she say, you can't say bruh. Bruh.
Right.
Two, standing on business, SOB.
Oh, they hating. Yeah, they hating.
This is racially biased, nigga.
They hating.
Number three, ooh wee ski yee.
Okay, I'm rolling with that right.
One. Please don't say that.
This don't even mean nothing.
Four, ski yee. Ski yee. So there's a difference between ooh wee ski yee and ski yee?
Maybe. What region?
That's a good question. I don't know where this motherfucker came from. Five, you ate that up.
You know, they be saying that to the teacher. You ate that up, Miss Johnson. You ate that up, Good lesson.
I can't stop saying that. All right, five. That's cat.
I could roll with that.
Seven. What's up, gang?
Nah, gang.
8? Bet.
Hell no. Nah.
I gotta say bet, bro. I gotta say bet. Kicked
out twice, nigga.
All right, 9. Oh my God, Miss T.
What?
Oh my God, Miss T. Maybe she got a fat butt. They be like, oh my God, Miss T.
She might be black then.
Yeah.
They be hating us and they be like, oh my God, Miss T.
She ain't no diva. All right.
Oh, that's crazy.
On God is number 10.
Nah.
11, on my mama.
Nah.
12, on my dead mom, dad, aunt, whoa, cousin, any family, friend, associate, et cetera.
Damn. Yeah, you can take that one out.
All right, 13, Riz.
I still don't even know what that means.
It means charisma.
No.
14, what's up, G-Wade? What's that, bro?
G-Wade? What?
I don't know what that's. I just knew you niggas was gonna know that one.
Nah, I ain't never heard.
What's up, G Way? I'm gonna start calling everybody G Way. Oh man, the cut with my twin is 15. 16, just vibe.
Nah, you gotta keep that one.
Yeah.
17, got
what?
Get damn.
Got G-Y-A-T, nigga. Got.
I don't even know. What's clap? What?
Nigga, you would say use it in a sentence if you need help.
Like goddamn?
Like God.
All right, bro, you got it. You got it, nigga.
Hey, what's the first thing you think when Shorty come in there? All right, I got one God. Your first God ever.
Goddamn.
Did you ever see the video Wangsta with 50 Cent?
Nah.
And old Shorty come walking in through the camera with that booty.
Nah, it's when Tip Drill first dropped.
Yeah. I'm about to pull it up. Hold on. I'm about to make you niggas say, God. Hold on. All right.
Man, Watson turned folder.
Man, fuck that.
That was a
anyways. All right, where we at?
About to pull up some
God, yeah, I forget. All right, 18 on bro, 19 on hood, 20 gang gang,
gang gang,
21 nigga, 22 on me.
Not a, that's a black dude.
22 on the set, 24 freak you mean, fuck you mean. I'm assuming. Mm-hmm. 25 period. 26 Munya. See, she got it wrong, so she must be white. She probably wasn't meant to say Nunya.
Okay, I was like,
but she said Munya. 27, big dog. Nah, what's wrong with that? 28, right. 28, motion and or big motion. Hell nah, we gonna keep big motion. You feel me? Yeah, 29, just vibe, twin. What's wrong with telling somebody just vibe, twin?
Yeah, this is very
racist. You know what I'm saying? 30, what's up, twin? 21, nah. And then 32 is given. I'm cool with 32 being off of the list.
Given?
It's giving.
Oh, yeah, that's.
Yeah, it's a little.
That's fried.
Yeah, shout out to that. Listeners, if you think this is a racist list, let us know. Because you know we don't know. We just say what we say and what we feel. You feel me? So let us know what you feel. Let us know what y'all feel about that. Also, I just want to tell everyone, if you have God, you have everything.
Big fact.
You feel me? I don't know if someone told you that. You know what I mean? Maybe you're just not aware of that or something, you know? Let me play with this young lady say. Now, let me preface this clip with, this is not like a shot. I don't want to go into 24 like with the narrative of all these like, you know, relationship advices, right? Like, oh, the black man and the black woman needs to do this or that on depending on what side you're on. And, you know, but I just thought that this was growth. I felt that this was growth. To hear this from a woman, right? So I'll play the clip. Let me know what y'all think of the clip. Damn, where'd it go? Oh, clip just disappeared.
It went gat.
Yeah, gat. This is up. This is all the way up. This is all the way up.
Yeah, that's true.
Bad. Says, men are not obsessed with women like they used to be. Y'all don't find that kind of weird? And to be honest, no, I don't find that kind of weird, because what exactly is there for men to be obsessed with in today's world? Women have left no room for imagination, none whatsoever. It's like your sense of entitlement is out of control. Your expectations are unrealistic. Y'all walk around showing your bodies half dressed, half exposed 24/7, out smoking, drinking, partying 24/7, on the scene 24/7. A lot of y'all are not even coming with nothing to the table because you're too busy with your hand out trying to see what man got the next bag so he can sponsor your lifestyle to make you look like you're living a lifestyle to post on the internet. It's like a lot of y'all don't have common sense. A lot of y'all don't know how to hold a conversation. A lot of y'all don't have no originality about yourselves. Everybody is getting the same body. Everybody is getting the same hairstyle. Everybody looks the exact same. And it's like, y'all get that confused. Oh, well, men like that. No, men will fuck that. But men are not biting that, cuffing that. And I think y'all are starting to realize that. And then the first thing y'all want to say is, oh, well, they're gay. They're sassy. No, they're not. They're just tired of what you guys are presenting. And if y'all are here to give them free pussy, free looks, and free everything they ain't got to work for, why would they? But they're never going to take you serious. So it seems to me like a lot of y'all are now starting to realize that you're either losing value or have lost value from chasing attention. And now that's something that y'all got to deal with, and y'all can't face that fact. Men love women that are exclusive.
She ate that.
Right. Eight. It's giving.
It's giving. Hey, God. Well, of course, we got things we need to work on too as men, right?
Facts.
You feel me? Let me say that. As men, we got shit we need to work on. But for shout sure. out to you. Shout out to Black women. Shout out to 2024. I want to ask y'all a question, man. What is something that you're believing God for in 2024? I know we talked about monetization, you know, the gifts, the blessings, right? We're going to get that. We worked hard for it. But is it something that we can really share that we, you know, something that you want God to really work inside of you? Like, what's something that you would say, you know what, 2024, I want
peace. It ain't from within. It's from the outside. I want peace. Like, that's what I'm praying for.
It starts with the inside, too, then.
Yeah, it's the same story,
but I get you, yes. Yep.
There's certain factors that try to take away from your peace. So I just keep praying that those factors stop being retarded.
Big about facts. You, no name, big facts. God damn.
Shit, from inside, some internal things I want to work on.
Yeah.
I think, I feel like I've been battling with trying to do too much, you know what I mean? So maybe focus.
Yeah.
Focus.
Yeah,
yeah, that'd be fine.
Yep. For me, it's like, it's a few of them, but number one is just being a lot more dedicated to my commitments, self-commitments. It's easy for me to go to my job. It's easy for me to, okay, baby mama need A, B, and C. I need to make sure that happens for her. My daughter needs A, B, and C. I need to do that. Those are things that kind of are held outside of you, right? You're like, you know what? I got accountability outside of myself, but there are certain things that I want to do and be consistent in that I need to be focused on my commitment with.
Mm-hmm.
You know, my commitment to, for instance, just working out more. You know, for the last few months after the baby, I've been saying this from the, after the baby's been hard for me. Like before the baby, I was in shape, I was good. You know what I mean? I was going at it. Y'all see my journey? I'll be hiking every day, like blah blah blah. But baby will change things, so. But I had to learn, like, that's not my excuse, you feel me? Like, everybody has a fucking baby, you know what I mean? For me, it's like, all right, find the way you can be consistent. So I got a gym membership. I need to cancel the shit because I ain't been to the gym in about a year. But I've been working out consistently at home now for probably about a month or two. I'm just getting back into it, you know what I mean? Whenever it was like I couldn't do my walks every day. You know what I mean? When I couldn't get outside and do my walk slash jog or my hiking, it got cold. I had to find a place to shift where usually, typically what would happen is I would just lay on the excuse. Like, I got a baby and I don't feel like driving. I got this new gig at work that I got to put a lot of time in. I ain't got time to go to the gym.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, nah, you got to make time for what you really, you know what I mean, need to make time for. And I really feel like God be telling me, like, man, you got to get that consistent routine for yourself, mm-hmm. far as your workout, healthy eating, down to even your vitamins. And it's coming into just the fact that I'm getting older. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, I'm getting older, bro. Like, I gotta do a little bit more than I used to have to do even just 3-4 years ago to just do, just to make half the fucking progress. You know what I mean? So you're getting older, you just, greatness is a process, bottom line, man.
Facts.
And just making that self-commitment. I think 2024 is one of those years where you just, you want to be self-committed, man. Find what you're looking for. Hold yourself accountable, man. Hold yourself accountable.
Yeah.
And we got it.
Yeah. I'm gang.
Hey, shout out to the gang, my nigga. Shout out to commitments. Yeah, man.
Facts, big facts.
Hey, we back, though. I ain't really got nothing else. Y'all got something else y'all want to chat up, bro? It was probably a short pile. I don't even know how many minutes it
2024.
Is.
2024. You know what I mean? Just blessings, you know what I mean?
Big blessings.
Year monetization, getting everything in line.
Yep.
2023 ended pretty good. Set me up for 2024, so just stepping into those blessings.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? Being grateful.
Stepping into them.
Appreciative.
Yeah.
Receive it.
Reach up and grab it, nigga.
Reach up and...
No, I got to do a shout-out to my pops, bro.
Shout-out pops.
So, you know what I'm saying? RIP my uncle, bro. My Uncle Lucius passed away on the 21st.
Damn.
Yeah. That's my nigga. So my dad, y'all know my dad, bro. Like, he real reserved. Like, he ain't, like, if he know you, he'll joke and be funny. But, like, in the, like, the group setting.
Yeah.
Like, so, you know how they do, like, where you can go up there and say, you know what I'm saying, say something. So he was the first person that went up there. Zay, I give you $20 right now if you tell me the phrase that he said to start.
God is good.
You was close, nigga.
What is it?
My nigga got up there. So mind you, I'm in like the third row. My sister Janae behind me. He got, and I could tell he was nervous because like he don't really be doing that. That nigga got up there. And my nigga said, "Grace and peace, everybody."
God.
I look back. Janae was looking at me. My sister was looking at me. We were just weak as hell.
Hey, shout out to that.
Nah, that shit was hilarious. But my nigga, he did his thing, man.
Hey, moments of pressure, you resort to what you know.
Exactly.
Hey, like, that's what he knew. Like, hey, it's the only time I've ever had to do it. This is the second time in 20 years, probably. Shit. Shout out to G. Shout out to your unk, man. Sorry for your loss.
Yeah, man. Shout out to Lucius.
It's always hard to lose people, man.
Yeah, facts.
Well, shit. Oh, I'm gonna play some music for y'all, dude.
Got some shit.
All right. Hold on. It was something I wanted to play.
Just a little something I wanna play.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You don't know what you do to me. Between me and you, I feel a chemistry.
This is a cover by Jordan Hawkins. That Aaliyah won in a million.
So no one else will love me like you do. That's why I don't mind to spend my life with you. I want to please you.
It's a lover's year.
Any way I can, I want to share my world. And don't you understand? Your love is a one in a million. It goes on and on and on. You give me a really good feeling. All day long, your life is one in a million. It goes on and on and on. You give me a really good feeling.
was heat.
That's fire.
Heater, heater.